Ladies and gentlemen, please prepare your hearts for an evening of worship and praise. Make welcome Fred Hammond and Radical for Christ.
Can you help me?
We have the marvelous, we have the marvelous, we have the marvelous.
Though to your goodness and your mercy I have surrendered everything inside of this. Just a prayer will bless your name. Come on, put your hands together if you know this. His love and greatness. All good things satisfy me. Can you hear me say?
I will.
Everything in me will fill the same. All that's inside is. Get on down for you, have Kenya, can you help me? When the battle gets tight, just believe that the Lord is gonna come and save you. You're more than a conqueror, say. It's your more than a conqueror, too. When the battle gets tight, just believe that the Lord is going to come and say to you and me to say, go get your hat and come on. Go get your vest and zip it up and come on. Go get your shoes. Go get your word. As a matter of fact, go get everything. Come on! Oh, you might as well just come on. Come on! Go get your shoes and come on! One, two, three, and. Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Just a few more steps, just a little. But an irate enemy is in the middle, and he's swearing there's no way I will complete it. I ain't playing, 'cause I know he is defeated. So but let's trust in the name of the Lord. His counsel is sure. His word will help us to endure. So, whenever you feel afraid, say, hey, hey.
Your name is holy.
see you like I should now walk a path that's right. Do the things you would. Give me a clean heart, and I will serve nobody but you. Give me a clean heart to lose the double mind, to leave you when you tell me everything will be just fine. Just lay your hands on me, Lord, and I will be brand new. Oh. Give me a clean heart, a better one, I pray, to believe you when you tell me, and stick with it all the way. Just lay your hands on me, Lord, and I will be brand new. My heart from fainting. This is all I know to do. Yeah. Just lay your hands on me, Lord, and I will be brand new. And I am worshiping your great and holy name. I'm determined. Won't you play now, won't you play? Nobody but you, hey, hey, hey. and I will serve. You, I will serve. I will serve. I will serve, yes. I will serve. Anybody need a clean heart? Listen. Keep that going down. I, in the midst of having an unclean heart, the Lord never judged me or exposed my heart to the public. I know y'all don't know nothing about that. But isn't it wonderful how, in the midst of the things that we struggle with, and then somebody will lie on you and say something that you ain't did. You know, they say you did something and you know you ain't did that. You know what I've learned to do? I've learned to rejoice when people lie on you. That's because the Lord himself has allowed them to make up some sort of falsehood. And he's taken the thing that you've really struggled with and he's hid it from your enemies. He said, oh, I'll never do this. I'll never expose him. That's why he gets so upset when we expose our brother. When we pull the covers off of our brother to gain an upper hand. The Lord has hid our junk, yet and still we expose others. I don't care what it is. We all need, whether it's pride or whatever it is. Now, I'd like for you to get that one thing in your mind that the Lord has hidden from the public. Oh, they lied on you. They said you was this and they said you was that, and that's not true. And maybe they almost hit it on the head one time. They almost got to it, but the Lord just, I want you to get that thing in your mind, because see, that thing could have destroyed you. It could have taken you down forever. You could have never come up after that one. But the mercy of God just stood strong. Said, not so. Get that one thing in your mind. With that one thing in your mind, these should be the words that you say to the Lord. Spared you. Just, this should be the words on your lips. Thank you.
There is no way that I know everybody don't have the same testimony. I know some of you don't know what it's like to walk in the emergency room and be laying on a bed and hear all of the beats and the tweets and know what it smells like and look at the doctors come and go out of your room and all the pain that you're in. I know some of you ain't never felt that before, so it's hard for you to say thank you. You've always had your health. You've always had your strength. You've had everything that you've ever needed. You don't know what it's like to be up there with tubes in your arm and your family around and they're trying to keep you up and your head splitting and your arm hurting and your back hurting and then you get evil reports that the doctor says, well, this doesn't look good and that doesn't look good, but you're standing here today. I know everybody can't feel that right there. I know that everybody don't understand what it's like to go into the work. They hand you a pink slip and say, it's over. I don't need you no more. I know some of y'all had a job all your life, and that's good. I know you don't know what it's like when that phone rings and it's every bill collector that you've ever heard. They're coming to get that little red car, and they're coming to get that little stereo set, and they're coming to get that little... And you got kids to look at. I know y'all don't understand that, and the kids are hungry, and you got to get something to eat. Everybody don't have the same reason to say thank you, but we all should be able to say thank you. Some of you don't even realize that you're here today. Just a few years ago, you was cutting a fool in the street, and somebody pulled a razor out, or somebody pulled a gun out, and you thought your life was over. You were dealing in the game, and they said, once you're in, you'll never get out, but you're standing here today, free and clear. The bottle had you. Alcoholism had you by the neck, and it said, I'll rule you forever, and I'm the king of your life, no matter what you try to do, and you try to speak in all sorts of tongues, but then you go right back to the bottle because of depression. But the Lord still had mercy on you, and he just began to just cover you till now you're free and clear. Whatever the reason is, you can say, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Wanna thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Lord, we bless you. Lord, we take this time to interrupt the service just to say thank you, Lord. Lord, we thank you. We're sorry that we haven't said it so many times, but Lord, we know that every minute of every hour of the day, we need to be saying thank you. Every time we turn our car over, Lord, and turn our key in the ignition, we need to say thank you. Every time it starts up, we need to say thank you. Every time we put our feet outside the bed in the morning to get up and start the day, we need to just say thank you, Lord, for a brand new day, a day I've never seen. And most of all, Lord, we thank you for the mercy, the brand new mercy that we see. As we look out in the morning sun, we see a brand new set of mercies and a brand new set of grace and a brand new set of compassion. Lord, we thank you because you've been so good. Many of our friends and family members, they can't say that this morning, Lord. They can't say that this evening because they're gone. But you've allowed us to stay here, witness another day. So we just take this time right now and say, thank you. And everyone said, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Put your hands together if you would. Now we're going to pray the prayer of protection over us in here. If that's all right, we're going to do like they did back in the old school day. They knew how to sing and get close to God. So if you don't mind, I want you to get ready to put your hands together and just say, Jesus, be safe. Vegas, y'all act like y'all know how we do this. Protection!
Protection!
I know we at the MGM and all, and this is a real fancy place, man, thing. But I want to know, that anybody need protection?
Protection.
That mean protection,
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 along the way. Can we speak the word of faith in this place? Can we speak the word of faith in this place? No matter what the enemy has had assigned to you, hold on 1 second. No matter what he's had assigned to you, what imps and what little demons he's attached to your life to try to make your life rough, to try to tear down your health and make you sick all the time, the devil is defeated because the blood of Jesus has been applied to our life. And we may have symptoms from time to time. That don't mean we're not going to feel symptoms, but from time to time. But you know we are healed by that. The body is set up to heal itself from the inside out. And that's the way the Lord said it. So the blood is there. So what does that mean? Simply, you have protection.
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 Protection. Protection.
Protection.
Protection. Strong tower, a strong tower, along the way, along the way, along the way, along the way. Hey, the blood prevails, the blood prevails, the blood of Jesus.
This place is for life, yeah.
should even try.
Don't bother, Jesus.
That's what they say.
Nothing to offer.
Stay in your place.
I didn't need you.
He had to choose. Can you help us sing? Can you help us sing?
Jesus,
I need you.
I need
you.
Please don't pass me by.
Don't pass me by, Jesus.
Jesus,
I need
you.
This is the honest truth, yeah. Could this simple one in this messed up life, could I ever serve you? People and things clutter my mind. Should I even try?
Nothing to offer.
Stay in your place.
I must admit,
when I think about it,
I need you in my life.
So I cry to you,
Jesus.
I need you. But I can't listen to the crowd or the situations in my life telling me to keep it down. I need
you. I know I'm broken.
I know.
But you can hear me. Jesus, Jesus, I'm calling you.
People say I'm worthless. But I'm
still.
I need you.
I'm crying, Savior, Savior, hear my humble cry.
Lord, yes, he is.
before we go, just say,
should be a fire in your heart
and a race when you race into me.
Assuming every part because you know
the
God we serve will make his presence known when you race.
You
race. When you race.
When you raise, should be
a fire in your heart,
and a race, when you raise, consuming. Stand up and say that there is none. Somebody need to say, when you praise, when they praise. Say, when we praise, and say, God is an awesome God. When you praise, come on, somebody in here. It's all right if you want to clap your hands if you want to. Bread of life sent down from glory. Many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter. You are the living word for him now. Sent down from glory,
many things you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter.
I wonder, can somebody say that with us?
You are the
bread of heaven,
heaven.
Sent down from glory, many things you were. A holy king,
a carpenter.
One more time, can you say it one more time? Bread of heaven, sent down from glory. Many things
you were on earth, a holy king, a carpenter.
Say, awesome ruler. Gentle Redeemer,
God with us,
the living truth we have in you. Awesome, awesome ruler, gentle
Redeemer,
God with us. This is what we like to say. Jesus, Jesus, say. That's what we call you.
Manger born.
But on a tree, you died to say. Let's not be confused. Let's call it by his name.
Jesus,
Jesus. That's what we call you.
That's what we call you.
You were born in a manger.
Jesus,
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 Jesus.
That's what we call you.
Manger born.
Oh,
Joe Pace in Colorado, Mass. Can we say it like this one time? Georgia Holy!
Georgia Holy! Can I get you to put your hands together and just say, oh Lord. Worship him tonight. Before we leave this place, we're getting ready to go home, but we want to take it like this. Somebody need to know it's always a good time to worship the name of the Lord.